Look at this little bouncy thing. Today I'm going to show. Today I'm going to be showing you a super quick hair hack in how to create heatless curls using
a dressing gown belt. I don't know about you, but I own at least 5 or 6 of these at home, so I'm sure you have one lying around somewhere.
We are going to take you from this to this. You just use a comb and just make sure you're parting the hair through the center and down to the nape of the neck. So you're splitting that hair in half. So we're gonna pop this into the center of the hair. Look how cute you look. Now, to begin with, you're going to start with the front section of the hair. You want to take about 2 to 3 inch strands to ensure that you get that nice, big, beachy, soft wave. If you want tighter curls, then I would take smaller strands, but today we're going slightly more bigger and beachier. So you're gonna grab this section of hair, take it over the tie, bring it under, and pull it quite tightly like this. Don't pull it too tight because you're gonna lose that volume from the roots. Then you are going to grab another section like this, pick up the hair that you had brought underneath, and then you're going to wrap it back over like this. You're going to repeat this method throughout the entire front sections of the hair. However, when you do run out of hair, just twist the hair around the tie all the way down to the bottom, like this. When you have reached the bottom, you are going to pick up the bottom of the tie, hold it together like this, and then you're going to use a little elastic like this, and tie this together. The reason why you're folding the belt over is because you don't want to imprint the hair elastic onto the hair, like this. Okay, Jake, so first of all, just make sure you're grabbing 2 to 3 inches worth, and then you're gonna wrap it around and under. Wrap it round. Ah! And then grab the next section, wrap it round. Amazing. And then grab that last section. That's it, and wrap it around all the way down to the bottom.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy.
There you go.
Okay, so we're gonna do this together. We're gonna do the back section. So we're going to grab, again, your large piece, bring it forwards, pop it under, and then we are going to grab the next section from the back. Hold it with the original piece and bring it over and under. And then we're gonna do the same for the last section. And then you are literally just gonna twist it all the way down to the bottom to meet the first half.
Cute!
Are going to tie it with your elastic again so we don't imprint the hair. So you can use this technique on damp hair or dry hair. I personally would do it before bed and sleep with this in.
So we're both gonna go back to work quickly and we'll see you at the end of the day for some results. Oz Hair and Beauty, Jake speaking.
Now it's time for the final results.
Look at this little bouncy thing. Look how cute. Look at your little pigtail. Look at these. Wow.
Do you know what? This will be really good for camping. You could come out of your tent and be like, oh. Okay, so when you've taken the tie off, just use your hands as claws and just brush through the curls. You can also use a wide tooth comb just to brush through. Considering this is without heat.
Yeah, I think it's pretty good.
You can leave it like this if you want to, but I like to put a little bit of texturizing spray in there to give it more body and more volume. I'm using the NAC High Volume. This is fantastic because it just gives it that extra volume and bounce. I'm now going to go in with the NAC done and dusted texturizing powder. This is just to maximize the volume at the roots. So you just tip it like this and you push.